Hello everyone, Adam here, and today some episode about RTL-SDR banned application. So the application that is banned and currently not available is OpenEar, which is a brilliant app allowing to decode not only analog transmissions but also TETRA, DMR, POCSAG, ADSB and stuff. So let's get started. So if you want to download this app, you need to contact the developer by sending an email to this. And why it is banned? Because it contains some code that is legally prohibited to use because it's somehow patented or something like this. But let's get started. When you download the app, it contains several files, the libraries. What you may need to make it work is a set of Microsoft Redistributable DLLs, so you need to maybe take a look for these. You can download them from the Microsoft site. And let's get started with the app. So the app, when started, looks like this. So as I mentioned, it can decode analog transmissions like AM, FM transmissions. But it also can decode, which is a main function of this, it can decode DMR and TETRA, but it cannot decrypt them. It can decode, but not decrypt. So if it is encrypted, you will not hear anything. But let's get started from AM. For example, I have an airport nearby and I have set some presets to this. Let's start with this one. Okay, this is an automatic gliding system. Let's see what pilots say over here. And then let's go to FM. And then let's start with DMR. So the digital transmissions, we probably have to wait a bit until someone speaks on the channel. Okay, we have DMR set and now let's wait until it syncs with the... Okay, as you can see, the DMR was decoded pretty well, so there was a transmission from the almost the border of my country due to repeaters available. It was I was able to hear it right here in the center of Poland. And right now let's see how the TETRA is decoded. So I must admit that in my area all the transmissions are actually encrypted. So this tool can show it, but it cannot decode it. For example, it can only show you the sync information. In my case, it is all encrypted. So I'm unable to decode anything. So this is a plenty of these transmissions right here. The owner of TETRA radio has paid some fee to encrypt all the data and it is currently not available to decode. Okay, so what else? What else can be done using this tool? So we can also decode ADSB messages from the airplanes. Let's see if it works. Probably I will have to adjust my antenna to receive anything. So let me do it. I have adjusted my antenna and as you can see, it starts to decode the transmission. So you can see a flight number and speed of the airplane. as well as a position and a number of messages that were received from the airplane. So it is as simple as pressing this button. It will automatically adjust to the frequency 1090 and start to decode the transmission. This tool also can decode POCSAG, so the pager messages. However, I'm unable to show you anything since I don't have any POCSAG working transmission station right here. So basically that's all I can tell you about this tool right now. Maybe some information about that also the squelch is available. We can play with this, but maybe later. You can also record the transmission to WAV file. You can set some offsets. Let's now play with the squelch setting. For example, you can have different preferences. So let me check what is the proper value for my airband transmissions. So minus 58, for example, works. As you can see, squelch works quite fine. Let's now see how the recording works. Okay, I've tried to record something. Let's see in the directory if there's any WAV file records. So it should appear in the directory records. Now we play it. I think something was recorded, however, there's only noise here, but probably I pressed in the bad moment. Let's now see how the offset and range works. So these two settings can adjust the waterfall display. We can even turn it off, so we'll get only this frequency domain display. And that's basically all, except that you can put here some presets that you can then switch via pressing a button like this. So let's get back to the DMR, for example. I think I've played too much with this. So the DMR goes here, but it's not yet decoded. We'll have to wait until it syncs with the data. Okay, guys, so that's basically all. I hope you enjoyed this little video. Remember that this application is not completely legal, so you download it and play with it on your own risk. It is not yet completed. It's not yet fully working. Sometimes it hangs. Sometimes it has some issues. These are the sources that you can even decode from the WAV file. It sometimes hangs, sometimes not works, but it's basically the easiest way to decode digital radio at the moment. If you don't know how to configure, for example, DSD plugin or how to configure SDR Trunk, that's the best option for you. Okay, thank you very much, and hope you enjoyed the video. Please leave me a like and subscribe my little channel. Thank you very much. Bye-bye.